Hello friends, welcome to this video where I'll be talking about the UDS message suppression. I have been asked lot of times this question about how do we suppress the positive message, how do we suppress a negative message in UDS, is it possible for all? And usually the people get confused between whenever message suppression is talking, they get confused between the positive message suppression and the negative message suppression. Okay, so I'll be talking about that part only today clearly and try to solve, give the answers to all those questions. This video is especially dedicated to all those more than 50 people have asked this question. So it's dedicated to all those guys. So enjoy. Okay, so UDS suppression, you know, UDS comes into picture when there is a tester is there. Tester is there and there is ECU network, right? So this is a CAN network in the bus. So let's say ECU 1 is there, which is connected. ECU 2 is there, which is connected. ECU 3 is there. Let's say it is connected here. Okay. So ending with 120 ohm. Ending with 120 ohm. Okay, if you're not familiar with this CAN protocol concept, then please go through my Udemy course, whose link I have put in the description of this video also. So there is a tester, so it also has a DB9 connector for CAN. Okay, so let's say this is connected to this network, right? Now the tester is connected to this network. Now let's say, when does a positive response message suppression happens, right? So there are various services in UDS, has various services. So in UDS, various services like routine control, read data by identifier, write data by identifier, read DTC, ROE, and we have security access. All these services are there, right? So in UDS, I basically classify the services into two categories. One is with sub function, and other is without sub function. Okay, so let's clarify like this. So remember that if you want to suppress the positive response message, it is possible only with those services which have the subfunction. And if doesn't have subfunction, like 22 doesn't have subfunction, 2E doesn't have subfunction, all this. Who has subfunction? The diagnostic session control has subfunction. The routine control has subfunction. Read DTC has subfunction, right? So with these services, it is possible to suppress positive message, response message. With this, suppression of positive message is not possible. So, when you talked about this positive message suppression, it's possible with those services, with sub function, right? So what is a function? Why I am telling that? Let us understand that. Let's say each service will be starting, request will be starting with service ID, SID, which is 1 byte, and we have sub function then, which is also 1 byte. In this 1 byte, you will be having 8 bits, right? So bit 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. This is LSB and this is MSB. And this is subfunction. Right. Okay. So in this particular MSB part of a subfunction is called as suppress positive response message indication bit. if this is 1, then suppression. If this is 0, then no suppression. Suppression of what? Suppression of positive. So that is the bit which you are talking here. Suppress positive response message indication bit. Okay, P stands for positive. Okay, so if you don't have a sub function itself for the service request, then there is no possibility of having this MSB part. SPRMIB bit itself is not there, so positive response will not be coming. For example, the service is 10 is having for diagnosis session control, diagnosis session change. So 10, if you want requesting for extended session 03, then you'll be getting a response with 5003. Okay, so here sub function is 03 in the binary format will become 00000011, right? So the SPR MIB bit is 0, so a positive response is expected. But if you don't want the positive response to come, then you have to make it as 1. So 10000011, that in hexadecimal will become hexadecimal 83. So if you request as 1083, then it will be executed, but no positive response will be given because the positive response message is suppressed. So now let's say that you are requesting for suppression of positive response message. Let's say 1083 you are requesting, but let's say in ECU it is not possible to execute, it is not able to enter the external diagnostic session. So let's say a negative response has been formed, right? So even though you are asking for suppressed positive response message, then also you will get the negative response message, that is 7F10 and NRC. Whatever reason it is not able to suppress, that response you will get. So you know that when a UDS is sending a request, a response is expected. It can be of positive, let's say positive response, or a negative response. Yes, it is positive. Okay. Then with this SPRMIB bit, you can only suppress a positive response. In this case, for the request, if the result is a negative response, then it will definitely be sent. So using this bit, you cannot suppress a negative response at all. Okay, so remember that. Many people get confused in this point, that's why I'm stressing. So can we repeat once more what has happened? How do you suppress a positive response? Positive response can be suppressed for only those services which have sub function. Sub function is of 1 byte. The most significant bit, MSB small b, okay, this represents something called as, this bit is known as SPRMIB. What is the full form of SPRMIB? Suppress positive response message indication bit. Okay, so if this bit is set as 1, then the message positive response will be suppressed. If this bit is 0, then positive response will not be suppressed. That is, positive response message will be sent. Okay, so we have taken example of diagnosis session control. If you send 1003 case 1, then if you are not suppressing a positive response message, so you will get, if it is get positive response, then 5003 is coming, then P2 server max, P2 star server max will come, but that is out of scope of this video discussion. If you are sending 1083 instead of that, this is use case 1, use case 2, and if positive response is coming, means if external diagnosis session is entered, then the positive response will be suppressed, so nothing will come back to the tester as a response. Okay, now case number 3 is 1083 is requested, but is not able to enter the external diagnosis session, not able to execute this request, not fulfilling this request. So NRC is formed, right, which is 1 byte, then it will not suppress a negative response, because you are not asked for suppressing the negative response. It is not possible also to suppress negative response in this case. So you will get 7F10, which is same as this service ID, and NRC is going to come. Whatever is the reason it is not able to enter, right? So these three cases should explain you about positive response suppression, right? Clear? Yeah. So in this case, and if the service does not have a sub function like 22 service, you will request a DID, let's say 22. The DID is, let's say, F124. Then is it possible to suppress positive response? No, because there is no sub function. So it's not possible to suppress this message indication. You have SID and next is DID itself, right? No sub function is there. So it's not possible to suppress the positive response for read data by identifier service, write data by identifier service also, because it also doesn't have your sub function. Okay, so that's about suppressing the positive response. Now let's talk about the negative message suppression. The negative message suppression is dependent on whether you are requesting with a physical ID and or a functional ID, right? To explain you in brief terms, I hope you know what is the meaning of physical addressing and functional addressing. But for those people who do not know, let's say you have a tester.
And then you have a EC network is ECU. ECU 1, ECU 2, ECU 3, ECU 4, this is ECU 5, 5 ECUs are in the network. Okay, and this is a canvas.
So if the tester is asking a particular ECU, then it will use physical addressing. If it is asking generally the whole network, then whole network, then it uses functional addressing. Okay, so can I say that the physical address is the tester's intended address for a particular ECU, and the functional address is the address of the whole network, right? So this will have physical address, let's say 7E0, this has 5E8, this has 292, this has 5D4, this has 89E, and the functional address, the address of this scan channel, is 7DF. Okay, so if the request is done with the ID 7E0 for a service, let's say 22 F1D3, this DID has to be read, this read data by identifier service with the CAN ID 7E0, then it will be sent here. So only this ECU will receive it, process it, and give the response back. It can be positive response or negative response. What will other ECUs do with this request? Since this is not a functional address and not their own physical address, so this request itself will not be entering any of these ECUs. They will reject it. They will ignore it. Okay, there is a concept called as a message filtering in CAN protocol. So message filtering, using message filtering, it will reject this request itself. This tester requested this service to 7E0 because it knows that this DID belongs to ECU1. That's why it's asked with the physical address. Now let's say there are cases where the tester wants to know or want to read a DID. Let's say D134 DID is there. It wants to read this DID, but it doesn't know which ECU owns it. So in that case, what it will do, it will use a functional address. Okay, so it will use a functional address and ask, what is the functional address? 7DF, okay, 22D134. It's like asking the whole class of ECUs. The one who knows the answer will shout out the answer, that is a positive response. Others will have to keep quiet. Now, this request 7DF is filtered in, it is allowed in all of the ECU, but only one ECU has this D134, let's say EC4 has. So EC4 will give positive response, and for others it doesn't have that DID, so it will be having a negative response, right? Negative, right? So in this case, when functional addressing is used, it's like the tester. The tester is a teacher and all the ECUs are the students, and the tester doesn't want to ask who has got my pen or who has got a red pen for me to do the correction of my papers, right? So he'll ask, who has got the red pen? So if any student has got the red pen, then he'll answer as, yes, miss, I have got the red pen. And all other students will keep quiet, right? It doesn't happen like one student will say, yes, ma'am, I have got red pen. And remaining all students will keep on saying, I don't have. That doesn't make sense. Similarly, in this case, the tester requests for a reading of a DID or request for a service. The ECU which has the positive response will send the positive response, and all other ECUs will not send any negative response. So in this case, what we say is, if a functional address is used, then negative response is suppressed. So what happens in negative response? For a physical addressing, is indicated for a particular ECU, then the positive or negative both are sent. In case of a functional addressing, is asked for entire ECU network, that is multiple ECUs. Okay, so ECU, let's say ECU 1 has ECU 2, ECU 3 does not have, so it will have a positive response, a negative response, negative response, right? So in this case, what happens? This positive response is sent, this one is suppressed, negative response is suppressed, okay? And this is called as suppression of negative response, right? Now, the third case is, let's say it belonged to ECU1. This has negative response, that the DID is not there. Let's say the out of range 31 NRC. Here also 31 NRC, DID is not present. Then that's when you'll get the NRC 31 request out of range. But here the request is like the DID is present, but it is having some negative response, which says you cannot read the DID with security access denied, right? 33, security access denied. Something like this, there's negative response is there. So the request was intended for ECU1 itself, but because there is some mistake in the negative request message, so if a negative response comes because of that, that time you cannot suppress the negative message. In that case, the negative response will be sent back to the tester, right? So there are some particular NRCs only for which you can get the negator suppress, you can suppress a negator response. Which are they? The service not supported, 11. Service not supported in active session for NRC 11. You can suppress it for, these are hexadecimal numbers, okay? Hexadecimal 7E, hexadecimal 7F. Then you have hexadecimal 31. Like some 4 or 5 NRCs are there for which you can do suppress the negative message. To response message suppression. Okay, so I hope this explanation makes you understand. When do you have a positive response suppression? When do you have a negative message suppression? And I hope after this video, you will not be confused with these UDS response message suppression concepts. Okay, so that's all for this video. So please subscribe this channel for keeping connected and ring that bell icon. And all the best. Whatever doubts you have and if your doubts is cleared or not, those points, please comment in the section so that I'll get to know if I have to make some modifications, etc. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.